Basically, AMD hadn't updated the 5000 series mobile graphics since 2019. It was, what, 3 years. 2019, 2020, 2000. And finally, 2021 made, they updated, but fine, that's not the point. So basically, there are three options. AMD Radeon, RX, 600M, 6700M, and 6800M. So the 6000, AMD Radeon RX 6000 series mobile graphics will first be available in ASUS ROG Strix G15 and Advantage Edition, and HP Omen 15, HP Omen 16 Advantage Edition, or AMD, something like that. So yeah, those will be available, and now these things are getting good. Mobile graphics are getting nice and, might I say, pretty useful. So there are some high frame rates again. I mean, the AMD Radeon RX 5000 series had pretty good frame rates too with multiple games, but this better. And now I think that, you know about the graphics card shortages? This might even help. See, the reason there is so much shortage of graphics cards is because people think that for gaming, you need to have graphics cards. Everybody likes gaming. So basically, I use the AMD Ryzen 3 3200G, which has integrated Vega Radeon graphics, which is pretty good, and which runs whatever games I throw at it. Fortnite, Valorant, you name it. Plus, I mean, but for Rocket League also, it does work. But the resolution is just better than my Xbox. Maybe that's the effect of not having a GPU. But as far as integrated graphics goes, that's pretty good, I might say. So if these companies make integrated graphics pretty good, then we won't need to buy GPUs. Maybe even gaming laptops could become something practical, because right now gaming desktops are a thing. Gaming laptops, that's maybe that's what majority of people have, but gaming desktops, they perform better because of better cooling and big GPUs. So along, you know about the NVIDIA RTX 3080 Ti, so basically, and the 3090, basically AMD learned their lesson from that and did not use DDR6, what was it called, yeah, GDDR6X, because heating issues. Also, I think it was something like, basically the problem in GDDR6X is that it uses overall more power than GDDR6. So that's the problem. That is why that these graphics do not have GDDR6X. GDDR6X do perform better, but then again they are getting issues. I mean, we saw what happened in 3090. So yeah, we should see some pretty good heatings, I'd say. Maybe not about 95 degrees. And you should really get worried about your PC or your laptop or desktop or whatever you have when it gets close to the 90 degree mark. That's probably a wake up call for you to upgrade your cooler. I mean, there's no real damage until, I guess, above 90, somewhere near above 90. But still, that's a wake up call. I mean, see, the problem with my old laptop was that it never ran any game. But this thing can run games. So the GPU goes up to 70 degrees. AMD launched their new mobile series graphics. Pretty good, I'd say. So, AMD Radeon RX 6600, 6700, and 6800. So the problem is that they're too good to be real. Maybe this would give mobile graphics a new position, but we'll have to wait until it comes out. But please throw your specs at you. The AMD Radeon 6600 have about, I think, video card VRAM of 8GB, 6700M of 10GB, and 6800M of 12GB. Now, I'd say that pretty good, right? I mean, even a GT 710 is able to run Fortnite. It's just lack of frame. But here, even there is enough VRAM if you just want to do casual gaming or maybe even a little bit of intensive gaming. And clock speed, game frequency is fine with the RTX. Sorry, the AMD Radeon RX, you get about like, you get about 2177 MHz, and with the 6700M and the 6800M, you get 2300 MHz. Good. Pretty good, actually. Now, obviously, you can have your own look at the graph or chart AMD made to represent the frames. Again, it's too good to be real. You'll have to wait till it comes out. And it comes out first in two laptops, HP Omen 16, AMD Edition, or Advantage, and Asus ROG Strix G15 Advantage. So yeah, we'll have to wait, and once this really becomes a thing, then maybe there won't be a GPU shortage. I mean, if you've seen the Omen laptop series, the Omen 15, HP Omen 15, it's filled of 1660 Ti and other NVIDIA graphics cards. So maybe this will give a competition to NVIDIA. I mean, it's around the corner, and we'll see how good it gets. But I still don't think it'll be able to compete with 3090. AMD has their own champ for the RX 3090. And while you can see that AMD has released their stuff too, on the other side, NVIDIA has too. You know about the 3080 Ti? Yeah, I'm making a video on that too. So, the thing is, if these do get good, if mobile graphics do get good, then maybe it would help the GPU shortage. And maybe this will be something that they'll actually be able to manufacture. Not like NVIDIA's excuse for GPU shortage. I mean, they made the 3080 Ti. You know why? Because it has half the RAM of the 3090, and you could make two 3080 Ti's with the resources of making one 3090. I don't see how that helps. I mean, the GPU shortage is hitting us pretty hard in the stomach right now, and prices of even the dumbest GPUs are going pretty up high. Can't really do anything, nor can I do anything about this rain, but we'll have to adjust. That's why, you know, I chose that when I was building or searching parts for a PC. First, I did look at graphics cards, right? I did look at them, but then I looked at my processor and integrated graphics. And I thought, I don't do any intensive gaming, I do only casual gaming. And this will be fine to make me do that, right? There'll be enough frame rates. My monitor, the basic monitor, 60 frame for HD, that's it. So, 60 hertz, I mean. So, it'll be good for now. And when the GPU shortage is over, I can maybe upgrade when the GPU shortage. So basically, I did not buy a graphics card thinking that For now, it'll work, but for better frames, I'll upgrade down the road. I'll upgrade down the road. And that's probably what you should do as well. Because, I mean, you could spend a lot of money and get a graphics card. Even the dumb ones, they're pretty high enough. But, or you could wait till the GPU shortage is over and save yourself from some money. And yeah, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe.